Gen is one of the most powerful tools in Max and is completely integrated into rnbo. rnbo supports Gen and all Gen objects and operators. This means you can utilize the existing library of Gen DSP audio effects or explore building your own in the Gen patching environment and deploy them into any of the available export targets, like the Raspberry Pi. Like in Max, you can create a Gen Tilder object in your rnbo Tilder patcher, or you can load Gen DSP audio files from disk. You can use Codebox if you prefer to knock up some quick scripting, port in some existing DSP code from musicdsp.org, for example, or develop something more detailed yourself. Codebox is only one way to use Gen, and it can be used freely with the regular Gen patching environment. Inside the Gen patcher, the workflow is the same whether you're in Max or rnbo. In this video, we'll cover some things you might want to keep in mind while using Gen inside of rnbo and some reasons why you might want to use it in your rnbo workflow. For creating your own delay and filter effects or utilizing the existing patch library, Gen's ability to process one sample at a time and create single sample feedback remains very useful and unique in the Max patching environment. rnbo processes vectors or blocks of samples just like MSP. So you can think of the audio being fed into your Gen patcher as being one block of samples that Gen processes one by one. You can springboard your work in rnbo by drawing from previous examples built into Max, your own library, and the Max community. Let's grab the Gen Gigaverb example from the inbuilt examples to add to our rnbo polysynth. Our Gen patcher uses some parameters to shape the reverb effect. We can access these at the top level of our rnbo patcher by setting the Gen objects attribute at exposeParams 1. This exposes Gen's parameters as attributes of the containing rnbo object and as parameters in the exported code. Each parameter is given a unique random name in the form of gen_object_a_number/parameter_name. You can set an explicit path name for the attribute by setting a variable name for the gen object in the object inspector, i.e. setting the gen variable name to foo will result in foo/and the parameter name. Similar to a Gen subpatcher, we can use setParam to set the parameters of a Gen patcher from the rnbo parent patcher. To reach the top level, connect a rnbo_param object to the inlet of the setParam connected to Gen. Let's do this for all the params in Gigaverb. If you want to design or modify your own filters in rnbo, Gen is the most powerful way to do this. There are also some really nice filters in the Gen Examples folder. Let's quickly bring in the low-res example and add it to our signal chain before the reverb. This time, our Gen patcher doesn't contain parameters and uses signal inlets to control the frequency and resonance. We can use rnbo's param tilder object to control these at signal rate. Once we copy and pasted the low-res Gen patcher into our rnbo patcher, duplicate and add a param tilder for the cutoff and another for the resonance. Param defaults to 0 to 1, so our resonance param doesn't require us to add limits. Many DSP algorithms perform calculations on the immediate sample memory. This Gen implementation of a resonant low-pass filter uses internal feedback connections to buffer the previous two samples inside history objects. In rnbo, if you need access to the immediate sample memory, use the history operator inside of Gen. For feedback connections that don't require the sample level domain, you can use the feedback tilde object in your rainbow patcher. Feedback operates in a similar way to the gen history operator, except it works by introducing a single vector buffer of delay. You can use the new vector size object to output the current vector size. This value will change depending on the settings of the target platform. This is a good reason to use gen, as you are guaranteed of operating on each sample within every one of these vectors. If you would like to learn more about gen, check out the additional resources linked below and visit cycling74.com, where there are many articles and tutorials featuring gen. Happy patching!